the awesome AK pistol, just begging for an arm brace. But I got no tools, I got no time, I'm short on cash. What to do? What to do? Introducing the Magna Brace. You pick up one of these guns, and it just is so cool. And you take it out, and it's just so much fun. You just can't believe how much fun this is. Well, you might have gotten it in the first place because you want it to be some kind of a practical self-defense weapon. And after a while of using it, you realize it's not really that practical for a self-defense weapon. So that's what we're talking about. We're talking about how to turn this fun gun into a practical self-defense weapon and something that's very important to me. I don't want to lose the fun. I want this to stay fun. So I don't want to make any permanent modifications to this gun. Everything I do to make it practical, I want it to be simple and reversible and really easy. And if possible, cheap. Well, I got some really good ideas for you today that I want to share. Now, last week, well, I'm gonna show you something here. This is my Pac-9. Now, here's a story. A lot of you guys that saw me when I first got this and started saying, hey, you better look at this because this thing is a pretty incredible gun. You saw me convert this all legally with, I added a buttstock and a folder. I got a variety of different magazines for it. I threaded the barrel. This is a really great, very inexpensive. I got this on Amazon. I don't know where it came from, but it's the right threads and it basically does the same job of moving the sound waves forward. So it's basically a linear compensator. So you might be wondering, well, if I went to the work of drilling and tapping my receiver and putting a folder on here, why don't I have it on there anymore? Well, I definitely think that a gun like this, a pistol, is a lot more practical if you can get a cheek weld. It helps in your aiming. But for a lot of fun shooting, you don't really need a cheek weld. Well, that's where the problem is. I don't like the fact that, and a lot of people don't like the fact, when you get one of these guns and you want to make it practical, you've got all this work. You got a drill and tap, you got an adapter to put on here, a folding mechanism, and it's a bit of work, and it's a lot of expense. You know, by the time you get your pistol arm brace and your buffer tube and your folding mechanism and your adapter, you've got well over $200 into this thing, all so that you can have a cheek weld. And that's fine. A lot of people put up with that for a long time. And one of the really cool things that's come out recently is a device that allows you to simply unscrew your pistol grip a little bit and slide this forked receiver onto the back, and then you tighten it back down again, and the pistol grip nut, the T-nut, holds your buttstock, or your, if you're SBRing, or your pistol arm brace if you're not, onto the gun, so you don't have to drill anything, which is really brilliant. That's a fantastic step forward. But I got a better one. Recently I discovered something that I think is going to change the gun world. It certainly does for me. One of the things I did with this Sega is put a folder on here. You can't get these anymore. Carolina Shooter Supply does not sell the Raptor stock anymore, which is unfortunate because I love this thing. But I simply put a folding mechanism on here and it works both ways. But here's the problem. Yes, this is a small gun. Yes, it takes quite a bit of the length off of the gun to be able to fold it. And everybody knows that you're just exchanging one kind of dimension for another. The gun is not thin anymore. It's bulky. It's more than twice as wide as it was when I started. But that's just something that people who want to put a folding buttstock on a gun or a pistol arm brace have accepted, because what else are you going to do? Well, that leads me to my new product that I'm really excited about. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to the Magna Brace. This thing is unbelievable. Incredibly good idea. It has a magnet, and you just stick it on right like that. Now, in case you're wondering about how sturdy this thing is, it's a very strong magnet. There is nothing about this that's going to come loose while you're using it. This is one of the cheapest pistol arm braces you'll find anywhere. After you consider the fact that it comes with its own buffer tube, so you don't have to buy that part. You don't have to buy some kind of an attachment to fit it onto your gun. You don't have to drill and tap anything. It's ready to go. And instead of folding and unfolding, you just take it off. So if you're talking about something that is small and you want to be able to put it in a backpack, if you stop and consider how you can configure this thing in a backpack to kind of fit it in there, it is far more versatile and adaptable than any folding mechanism you're going to find anywhere. So you just slap this guy on here. You have one, two, three different adjustment points. And I will tell you, this is probably the lightest you're going to find. You remember those SIG braces that came out in the very, very beginning, how heavy they were? I'll bet they're about 5 times as heavy as this thing. And except for the piece of Velcro on here, this is really kind of styled after those military M4 buttstocks, you know, the little ones that they use for going in and out of armored vehicles and so forth, the really compact ones. So, you know, when it comes to getting a cheek weld, this thing is perfect. It's all I need. It just gives me everything I need right here. And here's the cool thing. I only need one of them. So I take my guns out for a day of shooting. This will work on this one. It'll work on the Pac-9. It'll work on my M92. Anything with a steel receiver, this thing is perfect for. It gives me exactly what I need. All the way up to my Polish Hell Pup. Even though it has this little sling hook on here, it still works for that as well and gives me the cheek weld that I need. And the thing just works. It's a strong magnet. I don't know what kind of pull this has or where they get them, but it's an amazingly strong magnet. So this thing will work on any AK based weapon that you have with a steel receiver, which is pretty much all of them. Doesn't matter if it's milled, doesn't matter if it's stamped. The Magna Brace is made by a company called Rock & Lock. I can't give you a link. I'm sorry YouTube won't allow it. But the price for this is $69.95. Now, I bought enough pistol arm braces to know you will not be able to put something on your gun for anywhere near that cheap. And this has features that no other brace has anywhere. And if you go to their website, they have a place where you can enter a code. Enter MAX100 and you'll get 10% off of your purchase. This could be, for AK weapons anyway, the last pistol arm brace you will ever need. And it's probably the last one I'm ever gonna get too. Now, if it's an AR-based weapon, that's a different story. But for AKs, this thing does it all. I'm totally sold on it. All right, so after owning multiple rifle caliber pistols, I can tell you that I've come to the point in my life where I just want simple adaptability. I want the fun of this, and I want these to be easy to install quickly without tools so that I can do both, whether it be in training or at home. So to make the point, I'm going to do a complete conversion of this gun using all of these accessories, and we're going to time it to see how much trouble it really is to do. All right, are we ready, set, go. So I left the muzzle device off because that's how you get the maximum flash. So this will diminish our flash to an acceptable level for defensive situations, and it won't resemble a flashbang grenade anymore. The top cover can be replaced with this railed version with, I'm just going to take the red dot off so it's easier to install. And then we'll put the red dot back on. It always goes to zero, so that's no problem. And there you go. Just that fast. Cheek weld, red dot, flash hider. And honestly, for this, I would even consider getting some kind of an optic that had a built-in flashlight and laser. You got it all. You may want a more comfortable ergonomic grip. You may want a railed forend if you want to get fancy. But personally, this is everything for me. I couldn't possibly want a gun to do more than this will do. So, thanks for watching. This is Max Headspace 9mm.